whose rays are all ablaze with ever-living glory, does not deny his majesty, he scorns to tell a story. He don't exclaim, I blush for shame, so kindly be indulgent. But fierce and bold in fiery gold, he glories all.
Lights up well, so I for one don't blame while solemn shadows fall, sooner, later, over all.
Sing a merry madrigal,
sing a merry madrigal, sing a merry madrigal, ha.
I'm shedding witness my distress. Here's a pretty mess, here's a pretty mess.
Here's a state of things, to her life she clings. Matrimonial devotion doesn't seem to suit her notion. Burial it brings. Here's a state of things, here's a state of things.
With a passion that's intense, I worship and adore. But the laws of common sense, we ought them to ignore. If what I say is true, tis death to marry you. Here's a pretty state of things, here's a pretty howdy-do. Here's a pretty state of things, a pretty state of things.
Here's a howdy-do.
For if what he says is true, I cannot marry you. Here's a pretty, pretty state of things.
Here's a pretty howdy-do.
Daughter-in-law elect. Bow, bow to his daughter.
Mikado never did in Japan exist. To nobody second, I've certainly reckoned a true philanthropist. It is my very humane endeavor to make, to some extent, each evil liver a running river of harmless merriment. My object all sublime I shall achieve in time, to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make each prisoner pent, unwillingly represent a source of innocent merriment, of innocent merriment. Dull society sinners who chatter and bleat and bore are sent to hear sermons from mystical Germans who preach from 10 till 4. The amateur tenor whose vocal villain is all desire to shirk shall during off hours exhibit his powers to Madame Tussauds wax work. The lady who dyes a chemical yellow or stains her grey hair puce or pinches her figure is painted with vigor and a permanent walnut juice. The idiot who in a railway carriage scribbles on window panes, we only suffer to ride on a buffer in a parliamentary train. My object all sublime I shall achieve in time, to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make each prisoner pent, unwillingly represent a source of innocent merriment, of innocent merriment.
His object all sublime he will achieve in time, to let the punishment fit.
Advertising quack who wearies with tales of countless cures, his teeth I've enacted shall all be extracted by terrified amateurs. The music hall singer attends a series of masses and fugues and ops by Bach, interwoven with Spohr and Beethoven at classical Monday pops. The billiard sharp whom anyone catches, his doom's extremely hard, he's made to dwell in a dungeon cell on a spot that's always barred, and there he plays extravagant matches in fitless finger stalls on a cloth untrue with a twisted cue and elliptical all sublime I shall achieve in time, to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment fit the crime, and make each prisoner pent, unwillingly represent a source of innocent merriment, of innocent merriment.
His object all sublime he will achieve in time, to let the punishment fit the crime, the punishment.
As he dropped him down in a state of wild alarm, with a frightful, frantic, fearful frown, I bared my big right arm. I seized him by his little pigtail, and on his knees fell he. As he squirmed and struggled and gurgled and guggled, I drew my snicker snee. My snicker snee. Oh, never shall I forget the cry or the shriek that shriek at him, as I gnashed my teeth when from its sheath I drew my snicker-sneer.
With a smile well bred, and bowed three times to me. It was none of your impudent offhand nods, but as humble as would be. For it's clear in you the deference due to a man of a pedigree. And it's, oh, I vow, this deathly bow was a touching sight to see. Though trunkless, yet it couldn't forget the deference due to me.
His heart to you, his face the truth, whenever he finds a place. And in this place it all took place, exactly as he says, exactly, exactly, exactly.
Meritorious be.
shall bloom in the spring, tra la, every palm is of merry sunshine. As we merrily dance and we sing, tra la, we welcome the hope that they bring, tra la, of a summer of roses and wine, of a summer of roses and wine. And that's what we mean when we say that a thing is welcome as flowers that bloom in the spring. Tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la, the flowers that bloom in the spring. Tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la.
The flowers that bloom in the spring, ta-la, have nothing to do with the case. I've got to take under my wing, ta-la, a most unattractive old thing, ta-la, with a caricature of a face, with a caricature of a face. And that's what I mean when I say or I sing. Oh, bother the flowers that bloom in the spring, tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la, oh, bother the flowers of spring.
Tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la. I said to him, Dickie Bird, why do you sit singing willow, tit willow, tit willow? Is it weakness of intellect, birdie, I cried, or a rather tough worm in your little inside? With a shake of his poor little head, he replied, oh, willow, tit willow, it willow.
He slapped at his chest as he sat on that bough, singing willow, tit willow, tit willow, and a cold perspiration bespangled his brow. Oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. He sobbed and he sighed, and a gurgle he gave. Then he plunged himself into the billowy wave, and an echo arose from the suicide's grave. Oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. Now I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name isn't Willow, Tit Willow, Tit Willow. That was blighted affection that made him exclaim, oh, Willow, Tit Willow, Tit Willow. And if you remain callous and obdurate, I shall perish as he did, and you will know why, though I probably shall not exclaim as I die. Oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow.
There is beauty in the bellow of the blast. There is grandeur in the growling of the gale. There is eloquent outpouring when the lion is roaring and the tiger is the lashing of his tail.
Yes, I like to see a tiger from the Congo or the Niger, and especially when lashing of his tail.
Volcanoes have a splendor that is grim, and earthquakes only terrify the dolts. But to him who's scientific, there is nothing as terrific in the falling of a flight of thunderbolts.
Yes, in spite of all my meekness, if I have a little weakness, it's a passion for a flight of thunderbolts. If that dissonance seem dead down there, it's evident very hot is our one. Away we'll go and merrily, merrily, tonally, tarry till day is done. Extreme old age, do you fancy you are elderly enough? Information I'm requesting under subject interest is a maiden all the better when she's tough.
Throughout this wide dominion is the general opinion that she lasts a good deal longer when she's tough.
Are you old enough to marry, do you think? Won't you wait until you're 80 in the shade? There's a fascination frantic in the room and that romantic. Do you think you are sufficiently decayed?
To the matter that you mention, I have given some attention, and I think I'm sufficiently decayed.
If that is so, seem very down there, it's evident very hot is someone. Away we'll go and merrily, merrily, no time, tarry till day is done. If that is so, seem very down there, it's evident very hot is someone. Away we'll go and merrily.
Joy and once we've lost.